It is common knowledge that the course of Western philosophy began in ancient Greece, where the young culture of Athens made its first steps in the contemplation of what nature truly is. Throughout the centuries in ancient times and then from the Renaissance onward, all European scholars would be raised with thorough instruction in the philosophy of the Greeks, especially with regard to its two central figures, Plato and Aristotle, portrayed here in Raphael's famous painting, The School of Athens. Much attention was given to Socrates, who is often considered to be Greece's first great philosopher, admired for his teachings and heroized in his execution as a martyr of free thought. But with the widespread allure of these three philosophers, many others have since faded into the background. A great number of thinkers before Socrates who made interesting arguments and led fascinating lives. These are the Pre-Socratic philosophers. The original writing of these Pre-Socratics has been mostly lost. We know them largely through fragments and references from other ancient sources. But time has not diminished the mystical, profound quality of their thinking, much of which is actually fundamental to understanding their successors. In them, we find a blend of highly abstract thought with simple observation. They were able to extract cosmic principles just from the operations of nature which they saw around them every day. To them, the world's deepest secrets could be read directly from the ways in which it appeared. Their perceptions of the world continue to merit further attention and respect. Little is known about the life of Thales of Miletus, one of the first pre-Socratic philosophers, except that he successfully predicted a solar eclipse, a very rare and marvelous phenomenon in the ancient world. But this was a success of astronomy and mathematics, one which was repeated by several other people in various cultures. Thales of Miletus will be remembered through history for an idea far outside the realm of science, one which would make a statement about the entire universe and cosmos on the basis of his nearby surroundings. Normally, one would accept the everyday perception that nature consists of a large number of different elements and materials. But Thales of Miletus is known chiefly for one important puzzling thesis. The entire world and all kinds of things in it are made of water. Thales believed that water is the one basic substance that constitutes the universe. Every other thing and element that we see around us has taken its form from water and will eventually return to it. Friedrich Nietzsche, a renowned 19th century German philosopher and antiquities scholar, was of the opinion that Thales was the first true philosopher in the West. Thales' idea that the world is made from water is important in three ways, as Nietzsche notes.
Firstly, because it tells something about the primal origin of all things. Second, because it does so in language devoid of image or fable. and finally, because contained in it is the thought, all things are one. He begins to believe in nature by believing at least in water.
The early Greeks had generally thought the natural world as a screen over gods and divine forces. Nature had no independent reality, but was only a stage of illusion for superhuman beings. But for the first time, beginning with Thales, nature can have an existence of its own, in its own substance, without any divine involvement. He uses no stories and no images which characterize religion. Instead, he makes one generalizing statement to encompass the reality of all things. This makes Thales the first philosopher in the West.